This screencast of a fully customizable menu of Circle Lab system. And I will show you how it works. So, to edit the menu, you have to have the edit content rights, which I have already, and then find in the edit menu here the entry edit menu. And so there you can basically edit all entries you have here. Here we see lots of comments, and we see that all this on the left side is generated automatically using these group placeholders here that the system automatically fills. So we find an explanation for what is here, so the login menu will contain this here. Context dependent, of course, this will contain the labs, and the edit will contain the edit elements depending on the current visual. So if you want to add another one here, you can just write something, whatever you want, placeholder, and then you can assign the value. And the save, and what you will see is that the entry will appear in the syslog menu. This is this one here, so it will appear with the same button here. The same, and here you see the placeholder, and indeed when I click here, it will go to the relax system page. Okay, so maybe you want to have a space in between, so you can just add something else, instead of raw, or whatever you want, and just leave it empty. So the important thing is that the things on the left side are unique, so if you want put another one, you can then apply again because it's put over the value. You have to put block 2. And so now we see you can put two placeholders, two spaces here. Okay, so good. Good. So maybe we want to add the link in a new group. So we just put these brackets here saying my save, and here is you can either have my pointer group. Okay, so another thing you can do is you can restrict the visibility of the link. To do so, is explained here, you can just put an exclamation mark and then put some rights behind. So here are the possible rights, so if you want to show the link only for someone who authenticated and has the right to make schedules, for instance, you could put like 65. So when I put here 65, so save. So I have these rights, and when I change the rights now, it will make schedules. No. Then you see, okay, the menu vanished because I don't have the rights anymore. Okay, so, good. So this is especially useful to restrict links just for authenticated people, so just to give the one, because then when I log out, as you see, the menu went away. Here you also see that the menu changes context sensitive. Okay, so now I log on again. Okay, so here we see the link is still there in the group. And when I remove the restriction here, then everyone can see them. So it says if I would put like exclamation mark 0, and then the group is still there, I mean when I came outside, so when I look at it. Okay, so where else is this useful? So you could, for instance, put a track or whatever with some special pages just for the collectors, and yeah, you could do that here. Okay, so that's true. So one interesting feature is that you can also write a link to elements within the system. So this is how you do it. So you just write nothing, but just put an exclamation mark, and then you put the element name. So yeah, let's just take something here. Yeah, let's take that. This is just L3. So let's just link to the L3 here. So what we can do here is we just put L3. Okay, So now it's linking to the L3, which is a markdown label. And what you will see when I save is that when we link to an element that has a name, then the thing on the left is replaced by the element's name. So you will see here in a second that it says like markdown demo. Okay, I press save. And okay, as I told you, it's markdown demo. The interesting thing is that the rights of this link are the ones of the element itself. So let's have a look at the rights of the markdown demo. Okay, so it's always visible, and it's visible to everybody. And so let's log out. And okay, it's not visible. Because the reason is probably that that the pages within are not visible. So because those have rights. Okay, so now we should be visible. Okay, sorry. Why normally it should be visible. But well okay, as we see it's not working for levelness because it makes just a sense because they have interaction elements and to use interaction elements we have to be marked there. But what we can indeed do is we can just take one of these pages, so page 19 as we've seen, it's not access restricted so everyone can see it. And so we can just get to this page 19, let's do that. And P19. And so here we see again that it takes the name from this element. And so what I wanted to show you is that when I log out now, this should still be visible because it has the rights to that you can see. And it is not. So this is very interesting. So normally it should be visible. Well, but anyway, so it's really strange. So let's check that in here. Okay, so can we check that? Okay, here it says that it's only visible inside a collection, and as we've not been inside a collection, of course it was not visible. And so now, okay, so now it's as I expected. So yeah, it's good it didn't work, because now you've seen where there could be some problems. So, yeah, I knew it must work, because usually we have the starting pages and the course content and everything that come from within the system. And so, of course it has to work, because otherwise we could not see them. Okay, so I'm going to just set the rights back because I'm going to export this in a second. Then save. And yeah, but we've seen already what happens now. Good, then I will remove it again from the menu. And then yeah, see how the menu works. And yeah, it's very mighty, so it can do lots of things with it. And so if you want to link to something inside the system, it's a good idea to use reactive links as written here. Yeah. Alright, good. Then I save. And yeah, I hope you like the feature and enjoy the system.